Hi, it's Brett Elliott, medical herbalist, here about COVID-19. You may have heard the news, and I guess everybody's pretty aware of it, but there's a couple of things that are not being talked about and really being missed, especially by the authorities, by the government, by the health professionals, and so I thought I'd mention it in a little video. And possibly the most important thing is actually being completely overlooked. And we're wasting, I guess, a lot of people's time and potentially billions and trillions of dollars around the world by missing the key thing with the whole thing about COVID-19. And just a bit about me, I'm a medical herbalist. I've operated my clinic now for over 22 years and I've seen about 100,000 people during that time. And the thing with herbal medicine is it's quite different from pharmaceuticals or traditional allopathic mainstream medicine. Is when it comes to viruses and viral infections, the mainstream medical system really has no treatment. And that's why people are dying in hospitals, because they don't really have anything other than antibiotics and painkillers and anti-inflammatories and things like that, which have absolutely no effect whatsoever against viruses. And while they're madly searching for a vaccine, they'll never get it to everybody in time and, you know, be far too late. And the health authorities are not talking about building up your immune system. And the reason they're not doing this is because mainstream pharmaceutical medicine has absolutely nothing that can build up your immune system and give you a stronger immunity. Yes, vaccines can help your body produce antibodies, but like I said, they're not going to be available in time. So what we need to do is build up our immune systems. And this is, I'm really surprised, I'm amazed, in fact, that the media, the health system, the doctors, the professionals are not saying anything about this. And so they're completely overlooking the most important thing, because a compromised immune system, we know, is the number one reason why you get badly sick when you contract a virus. And COVID-19 is no different. In fact, if you have a compromised immune system, you're likely to get severe symptoms and possibly it could be fatal, as we know. So let's talk about what you can do and what you should be doing and what nobody's telling you that you should be doing, which is build up your immune system. So there's a number of things, and I've got a list here which I'm going to go through of things you can do to build up your immune system. And these are really simple things, and most importantly, we can do it ourselves, we can do it at home, we don't need medical professionals to deal with it for us. And if we do build up our immune systems and we get the infection, we're far more likely to get mild symptoms and recover very, very quickly. So, for example, with your foods, there's a lot of simple things you can do with your foods. One of them is avoiding sugar, avoiding processed foods, avoiding foods that are toxic to your body, like with full of processed additives, chemicals, avoiding too much acid-forming inflammatory foods like red meat and cheese and bread and pasta and all those glutinous, sugary and heavy protein foods, which are highly inflammatory. That'll put your immune system under stress, and we don't need to do that. So you're better off to have a lot of alkalizing foods, fruits and vegetables. But these foods in particular are very, very good for building your immune system, and especially garlic. Garlic is probably the number one thing you could do, and I would say doing 6 to 8 cloves a day of garlic. And what I recommend doing is actually swallowing whole cloves of garlic. If you think there's something around, or if you've been exposed to anybody potentially that had the virus, or even if you're going into a situation where you might be exposed, is consume large amounts of garlic every day. And raw garlic is the most effective, because raw garlic has the sulfates and the sulfides, which are the active component, and they are extremely good for protecting you against all kinds of viruses and bacteria and building your immune function. So most important is garlic. Then you've got mushrooms. Mushrooms contain what's called beta-glucans, which are communication factors within the immune system. So they help your immune system to communicate within a lot better. So a variety of mushrooms are good, especially the Chinese dried mushrooms, shiitake, reishi, maitake, those kind of mushrooms, extremely good. But any mushrooms, if you consume a lot of mushrooms, you will help boost your immune system. So there's a good combination. Mushroom soup with a lot of garlic in it. And chop in the raw garlic towards the end. Then you've got simple herbs that we use quite often. Turmeric is extremely good. It's a powerful anti-inflammatory. Thyme, the green thyme that you would maybe put on your fish, is very, very broad spectrum antiviral, and it's particularly good for the the nose, throat, lungs, and that area. Something else we should do is colloidal silver. Now, colloidal silver is a broad spectrum antiviral that's been used for centuries. And in fact, nowadays they use it in place of antiseptics and even spa pools to kill all the bugs, because it's broad spectrum, it kills basically everything. Not only that, but it's a tonic for your immune system. And yeah, those are really good. Now, the other thing is that's most important with building your immune system is your gut health. So your gut houses 80% of your immune cells, and it houses 80% of the immunoglobulin producing cells, which are the same as the cells in your lungs, which produce the immunoglobulins, which help your immune system to coordinate an attack on any kind of invaders. So it's most important to have good gut health. And again, avoiding all those processed foods, inflammatory foods, all the processed wheat products and meats, and help your gut to calm down. But I also recommend doing aloe vera. Aloe vera is a broad spectrum antimicrobial. It'll help your gut immune system to function better, to give it some more support and time and space.